Let's enter into the open world.
EdX offers online courses and classes pertaining to a variety of domains from best universities of the world free of cost. OpenEdX is the open source platform that powers EdX. All EdX code is freely available to the developer community. IIT Bombay X is an initiative of IIT Bombay to put all the educational materials from its undergraduate and graduate level courses online freely, openly available to anyone and anywhere in India. Through their project, Dr. Fartak Sir's group have tried to make enhancement to the Open EdX group, EdX platform, under the guidance of Shukla Nag ma'am.
A very good evening to one and all. I'm Neha Gadgil from VNIT Nagpur. Me and this group of 13 interns working under Dr. Patak will be presenting the work on the following project, Enhancement of IIT Bombay X, Open EdX. We all use various web applications every day. However, little do we know that we are leaving back a long trail of our activities on the platform. Various applications like EdX analyze all our activities and draw meaningful insights from them. From our project, we have done the same thing. We have taken those event logs, parsed them, and tried to get some meaningful analysis out of those, and also tried to answer some questions that haven't been answered before. Now, big data. The event logs that are captured are done in order of millions every day. Hence, they culminate into big data. Big data, what is this big data? As the name suggests, it is a huge collection of data. It comprises of three V's, that is the extreme volume, wide variety, and velocity at which it must be processed. Big data analytics is often associated with cloud computing, since the analysis of large data sets in real time requires a platform like Hadoop to store the large data and distributed cluster and MapReduce to coordinate, combine, and process data from multiple sources. Now, what falls under this big data? It is broadly classified into three types, that is semi-structured, structured, and unstructured data. So this is just a list of technologies that we have used. And then I would like to hand it over to the parser group that have parsed the event logs.
Good evening to one and all. I'm Aditya, and we have done event log parsing. Event is captured when someone clicks on IIT Bombay site. And this, when the event is generated, it would be in form of JSON objects, and the corresponding log record is stored in a file. What we need to do is we need to read the log file and extract the necessary information. What OpenEdX does? Let us say there is a task which requires a processing of a certain set of log data. It gets the data from a centralized parser, which will separate particular log files and generate to the task. If there are multiple tasks operating on same set of data, then each data must be passed multiple times. And this will reduce, it will increase processing. So we need commit a new model. In our model, we will parse once, store the result in temporarily in a database. The code we are having is completely hard-coded for each event. What we have done is we have generalized the parser. As it is already hard-coded, we need to know all event types before. Whenever there is a new event occurs, it is difficult to add, as we need to change the code again. We have generalized the parser. That is, it is suitable for all kind of events. We have stored all the events, event types, and the attributes in a database. And we will search for the event type field in a JSON object with the database data we are having. Let us here the event type name is discussion. We will check the JSON object with the check string. If it is matches, then the corresponding event type and name are noted, and it is further processed. These are some of the event attributes. Okay. This is what the flow we have described. Whenever the new data event occurs, we will output the particular line number and the kind of attribute or an event in a particular file. Here it indicates that this is a log file, then log file name, and at particular line 159, and corresponding to EdX course enrollment, a user ID attribute is found. And at line number 96, we could find that change email event is found. This is how we will identify new events and we will enter into database. OpenEdX doesn't include parser related to discussions we haven't found in insights, but our parser can identify all discussion events and parse accordingly. These are some of the discussion events generated whenever someone opens a form or sees a particular thread in a discussion. problem existing for log records. Some of the events doesn't have necessary information to accept it, like upload doesn't correspond to which discussion they are uploading. Okay, I will hand over to next group.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Nikhil, and I am going to explain how the existing analytics of the EDX platform works. This is a flow diagram of the whole EDX analytics pipeline. Whenever a student takes a course, he interacts with the LMS, and every student activity is recorded as a log, as a JSON object in the log files. And these logs files are stored in the Amazon S3 service. For our own purpose, we have used the HDFS to store all the logs. And then all the logs files are fetched to the EDX analytics pipeline. In the EDX analytics pipeline, most of the computation is done using the Hadoop MapReduce job. And after the analytics has been done, the results are stored in the MySQL database. And to show the instructor the analysis of the course, we bring it on the EDX Insight server using the EDX Analytics API. What Analytics API does, it's just do the simple queries to the result stored database and then show it to the EDX Insights. EDX Insight is a place where an instructor can see the course analytics. It has been divided into three parts: the enrollment, engagement, and the performance. So the enrollment shows how many students have been enrolled and every activity related to the enrollment, and then they show related to the engagement and the performance. What EDX Insight can help is an instructor can modify its course according to the analytics. So there are few tasks that has been defined in the EDX analytics pipeline that has to be run periodically so that the data on the insights update every time. So these are the various tasks, the answer distribution workflow. What it does, it has to run every night, and it updates the performance content of the analytics course. And like import enrollments into MySQL, it is for the enrollment, and the course activity weekly task, it is for the engagement activity. So to do the analytics on our own local server, what we have to do, first we build the EDX analytics pipeline on our remote server. And we note down all the errors that we face while building the system and while running the system. And this was a command that was used for running the pipeline for the import enrollment into MySQL, all the activities related to the import enrollments. And this is the table that was generated after that. And from one of the tables, yes, you can see the course enrollment daily. It shows how many students have been enrolled in a particular course on a daily basis. For example, here we have taken the CS101, and on the 2nd February 2015, according to the logs, 20 students have been enrolled. And on the daily basis, these are the students that have been enrolled. Now I will hand over to the Vedant.
The task assigned to us was to convert Hadoop MapReduce task to LuigiSpark. This was because the current EDX pipeline uses Hadoop MapReduce, which is lower in time efficiency as compared to Apache Spark. This is because LuigiSpark uses RDD, which stores data transparently in RAM rather than writing it in disk. So we saved cost due to the read-write operations. So these are the advantages. Speed was a major factor, and the benchmark set for that was that it runs at least 100 times faster than Hadoop MapReduce. The only disadvantage was that it uses more RAM, and because being in the early stages of development, it is still recovering from bugs. What we did was we successfully converted two of the EDX pipeline tasks into LuigiSpark tasks. The first one was course enrollment, which calculates the net change in the enrolled users per date per course. So for this, all the event logs corresponding to user.
Can I not get it from without analytics? Number of users who are logged into the course?
So it calculates the change per day. So that would be a huge amount of tasks to do. So that's where we require big data. For computing it fast, for every day we have to run that.
So it tells more information about the enrollment, just like the enrollment according to the demographics. In this city, the more students are enrolled, and enrollment according to the age group, it shows all that data.
No, you are finding out enrollment from a log event.
Yes.
Okay. The enrollment event generates a MySQL record. Okay. So I can do it from MySQL very easily. Why I have to do all these things?
Because the data is very large, that way we have to use the Hadoop MapReduce.
Very, very large.
No, sir, the logs are very large.
But why should I get this event from a log?
No, no, this is for part J enrollment. That is to keep
the chain how the enrollment is done. But that is an SQL query, no? Because I'm sure SQL has when he was enrolled.
No, the part J enrollment.
What name?
Part J enrollment.
Yeah, but per day enrollment, if the enrollment time is there in SQL, which it should be, okay, if it is there, then I will have to query.
What
you have
said is somebody can
So there are many courses that run, and a user can de-enroll on a given date many times. So the data would be huge.
You can put a flag.
No, what I am saying is an event, okay, which has got two impacts. Okay, one is entering into the SQL MySQL database. Okay. Which I presume should have a timestamp. Okay. I don't know whether it has. Okay. Right. The other is an event log. Okay. Which is one of millions. Why should I process one of millions when a single SQL database query will give me what time that event occurred if it has got a timestamp? Okay. If it has got a timestamp, I can write a select query, right?
So whenever the user enrolls or de-enrolls, we get a log event corresponding to that event with the event type being whether he had enrolled or de-enrolled. And we load all that into an RDD. We get a key value pair corresponding to the course ID, user ID, and the timestamp at which it occurred, and the action value, which was 1 or minus 1, corresponding to activation or deactivation. Then this value are these values are passed to a mapper where we sort all the timestamps according timestamps and get the last value of the get the status of the user at the end of the day so that we can calculate the net change. So summing up those values will give us the net change in enrollment per day per user per course.